Good morning, Supernovas. Just to let you know, we've now moved to in-person meetings in our site, so come along to those. We thought we would keep a few things still online, so this video will contain a talk, a little bit of worship, and a time for you to pray with your parents or adults if you wanted to. Have a great time this morning on Supernovas Online, and we hope to see you in our sites again soon.
This is the day of favor. Good news is in the air. Hope has arrived in Jesus. Our rescue starts right here. Oh, what kind of love searches the dark, trades all he's got to bring us home. What kind of grace runs to our aid, lays down his life when we're sinking. Your love has turned us around, set our feet on solid ground, set our feet on solid ground. Your faithful love has turned us around, set our feet on solid ground, set our feet on solid ground. Instead of ashes, mourning replaced with joy. Praises instead of sorrow, victory is our cry. Oh, what kind of love searches the dark, traits all he's got to bring us home. What kind of grace runs to our aid, lays down his down. We're running out of the prison doors, running into life with our chains undone. We hear the sound of your miracles, bringing hearts to life, bringing strongholds down. We're running out of the prison doors, running into life with our chains undone. With our chains undone.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. Questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, oh, you are the peace in my darkness, I will follow you, oh my lighthouse, my lighthouse. I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
The Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
Jesus taught everyone about God's love. All kinds of people would come to hear Jesus speak, including tax collectors and people who made bad choices. This made the Pharisees and Jewish leaders mad.
Ugh, yuck.
They didn't think that Jesus should be around these kind of people. So Jesus told them this story. Suppose a woman has 10 silver coins. And loses one. Won't she light a lamp and sweep the entire house and search carefully until she finds it?
Woo-hoo!
And when she finds it,
Hey, come here.
She will call in her friends and neighbors and say, "Celebrate with me and rejoice, because I have found my lost coin." In the same way, the angels of God are joyful and rejoice when even one person stops sinning and follows God.
Hi, Supernovas. So you just watched the video on the parable of the lost coin. Not like this coin, but one similar. And just to get this started, we've done a little video to get your mind thinking about it. So watch this video to get you going.
Okay, Right, kids, time to school.
To school without him. He was missing, so we had to go and find him. He was important to us. A bit like the coin was to the lady. The coin was important. Now, another point about the coins is that the Bible says here that she had 10 silver coins or 10 drachmas. Now, a drachma or a silver coin was worth a day's wages. So in this day and age, that would be worth about a lot of money. That's roughly about £120 or between 120 and 170. So imagine if you lost all this money. Do you think you'd go and find it? I know if I lost all this money, I would be searching my house for it. Especially imagine what you could buy with all that money. That was worth a lot. So not only was it not making it complete, the lost coin, it was also worth a lot to the woman. So the lost coin, it had a purpose. It was part of a set of 10, so it had to be found. It was part of that set of 10. Just like Peter has a purpose in our being part of our family, that coin had a purpose. But the coin was also worth a lot. It was worth a whole day's wages, so it's very special and precious to the woman, and she needed to find it. And do you know what? Jesus talks about that you are like that lost coin. You make up, you are part of God's family. If he's called you to be part of his family, you are part of his family, and you are worth a lot in the same way that that coin is. And you are very precious in God's sight as well. And so that's why if you don't know Jesus, then do you know what? God is pursuing you because he wants you to be part of his family. He wants to go and look for you. Like we went and looked for Peter. He's looking for you. He's pursuing you, and he wants you to be part of his family. And it's because you're so precious and you're worth a lot. That coin was worth a lot to the lady. So it had to be found. And do you know what happened when the lady actually found the coin? Do you know what happened? So let's just read it again. So she says, when she finds it, she calls her friends and neighbours together and says, rejoice with me, I have found my lost coin. So she said, let's have a party. Found my lost balloon. And my lost balloon, my lost coin. And so she was so excited, she went and told all her friends and neighbours. And the Bible says, in the same way I tell you, there is rejoicing in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. Now that means, in the same way, the same rejoicing like the woman had with the lost coin, God rejoices in the same way when one sinner repents. Now repent is when you choose, so say you're going your own way, this way. I'm going to do things my way. I want to watch TV when I want. I want to be nasty to my brothers and sisters because they annoy me. I want the best portion of food. I want this, I want that. And you suddenly realise, oh, no, Jesus has died for me so that I don't have to have this hard heart and want to go my way, because my way actually doesn't lead anywhere good. And Jesus says, if you repent, and repent means turning away, so you turn away from your old way of life, and you go God's way. You say, I'm going to follow you, Jesus. You died on the cross for me. You set me free from all the old, the consequences of all my bad stuff. And you set me free to go your way and live an even better life than my other life. And so God says, when that happens, there is a massive party in heaven when you choose to go from your way and go God's way and say, Jesus, you paid the price for me on the cross. You set me free. I said, you know what? Today, if you want to be part of God's family, and if you want to have that, know that that party is going on in heaven for you, then all you need to do is realize that your way of life really sucks. And you just need to say, God, I need you. Jesus, I'm sorry for going my way, because my way doesn't work. It doesn't give me any joy. It doesn't give me any continuous happiness. It doesn't set me free from the consequences of my naughtiness, the results of my naughtiness. But actually, I'm sorry for all that rubbish. I'm sorry for going this way. And I want to go your way. I want to have everlasting joy and things for all eternity, where there's a massive party in heaven, and that party is going to go on for all eternity, because God says there's a massive celebration and feasting in heaven, and it's a good thing. And so, like that coin, like that woman, search for that coin. God is searching for you because he loves you so much and he wants you to be part of his family. So I'm just going to say a little prayer, and if you want to join with me and take that choice now, make that decision to become part of God's family and say yes, then just follow me in this prayer. Father God, I just want to thank you so much for what Jesus did on the cross in dying for me in my place. I'm sorry that I always seem to want to go my way, but I choose now to stop going that way, and I want to say sorry for not going your way, and I choose now to follow you, Jesus, and to go your way, and say thank you for dying on the cross for me. Forgive me, Father, and help me to love you and follow you, Jesus, for the rest of my life. Amen. Now, if you've prayed that prayer and you've meant it in your heart, God will know, then there's a massive party going on in heaven. And you can tell someone at Supernovas now, tell one of your leaders, tell your mum and dad when you get home, and they can get excited as well, because it is the best thing. I did it when I was about 6 or 7 and never looked back, and it is amazing. So like that lost coin, there'll be a massive party for finding that, and there'll be a great, great repercussion and great result. You know, you'll find out one day that it's worth it. But anyway, just to say that God loves you and you're very precious in his sight, and you have a purpose, and he's pursuing you.
When I feel broken, there's never a day.